Hello students, today we are going to learn about construction and working of Western type synchronous code. So in this class I am going to say about construction and working of Western type synchronous code. Before going to what is Western type synchronous scope, first we have to discuss some basic topics regarding this synchronous scope. So before entering into the original chapter, so first we have to know which machine produces electrical energy in generating stations. So we already know that as an electrical students, in power generating stations, power will be produced and that will be consumed by the consumers. So in the power generating stations, one machine will be there. So that machine will produce power. So that machine will generate power. So that machine is nothing but it is an alternator. So alternator is a electrical machine, so which is used in the power generating stations to generate the power. So alternator is a AC generator. It is called as an AC generator also. So with the help of the alternator we will generate the power in the generating stations. So we are having some link between this alternators and why we are going to use these alternators, all those things. So next, why alternators are connected in parallel in generating stations? In generating stations only one alternator will be not there, so there will be more than one alternator. That means two or three alternators will be there. So minimum there will be two alternators. Why? Because so if any one alternator may get repair or may damaged, so then another alternator is used to generate the power. Why? Because power generating stations should always generate the power. So for that purpose there should be some additional generator. So that is nothing but the alternator to generate the power. So therefore we will use two alternators, and these two alternators are connected in parallel. So why these alternators are connected in parallel means, so just for load sharing purpose and for reliability of supply. That means for the continuous supply and for load sharing. For example, if sudden load increases on the power station, so then what happens? Only one generator is not suitable to generate the power. So at that time, so two generators, that means two alternators are used to generate the power. So that is nothing but the load sharing. So here, so whenever we are going to connect the two alternators in parallel, so we have to follow some conditions. So those are nothing but the conditions necessary for parallel operation of alternators. The same thing will be there in the parallel operation of DC generators also, but here we are talking regarding the alternators. Why? Because our topic deals with the alternators only. So here some conditions should be satisfied to connect the two alternators in parallel. So those conditions are, first main condition is the terminal voltage of incoming alternator must be equal to the bus bar voltage. Whatever the alternator you are going to connect in parallel to the another alternator, first of all the connecting alternator voltage should be same. So that should be same as a bus bar voltage, and the frequency of incoming alternator must be equal to the bus bar frequency. That means the frequency of the incoming alternator and the bus bar frequency should be also same, and phase sequence of incoming alternator must be equal to bus bar frequency. So here the phase sequence of the incoming alternator must be also equal. So these are the some conditions. With these conditions only we will do the parallel operation of alternators as well as DC generators also. But in DC generators there will be no frequency, only we will go for the first two points. And here, So first we have to know what do you mean by the synchronizations. What is the meaning of a word synchronization? So synchronization means, so switching on the incoming alternator to the bus bar when conditions are satisfied. That means whenever we are going to connect the another alternator additional to the bus bar, so then the conditions which are satisfied for connecting that alternator, so the total process is called as synchronization. So that is nothing but connecting one alternator to the bus bar when all these voltages, frequencies are equal and phase sequences are equal. So at that time we will switch the incoming alternator to the bus bar. That means we will connect the incoming alternator to the bus bar. So this total process is called as a synchronization. So here the incoming machine will be switched on to the bus bar when the above conditions are satisfied. That means whatever the condition just we have discussed, so if that conditions are satisfied, then it is very easy to connect the alternator to the bus bar. And how will you know that above conditions are satisfied? This is the main condition. So now we are getting near to our topic. How you will know that the above conditions are satisfied? That means, so we are not having any voltmeters and we are not having any frequency meters there. So why? Because there we are generating high voltages and it is not necessary to use all these potential transformers, current transformers for measuring the voltmeter voltage and currents. But here, so by doing something, we have to know that the above conditions are satisfied. That means the bus bar voltage and the alternate voltage is same, frequency is same, phase sequence is same. So the condition should be satisfied, means these all things should be same. So for that, a synchronoscope indicates difference in phase and frequency of voltages of the bus bars and the moving machine. So for synchronization purpose, for doing the synchronization process, we will use a synchronoscope. So this synchronoscope, what it will do, it will indicates the differences in phase and frequency of voltage. If there is a difference in phase, that means if you are not connected in same phase, if you are not connected with the same voltages or same frequencies with the bus bar and the moving machines, so then it will indicate by showing some buzzer or by showing some any indication. So like that, a synchronoscope will indicate that if these conditions are not satisfied. If the conditions are satisfied, then it will give another signal. So with the help of that signal, we can know that okay, the conditions are satisfied, so therefore we can synchronize. So the synchronoscope is a instrument which is used to synchronize the alternator. So here we are going to know about this synchronoscope. A synchronoscope is a device which is used to synchronize the alternator with the another alternator or bus bar. So here you can see it is a single phase device. It is used to determine correct instant of closing the switch. That means it is used to determine where we have to synchronize the alternator to the bus bars. So this is necessary when unloaded machines is to be connected to the bus bars in order to share the load. By doing the load sharing or by doing anything, why? Because whenever we are going to connect or we are going to synchronize the two alternators or we are going to synchronize the alternator with the bus bar, then definitely we have to use a synchronous scope. So here, so synchronous scope will indicate the differences in phase and frequency of voltages of bus bars and the moving machines. So next we are going to see what are the types of synchronoscopes. So we are having two types of synchronoscopes. First one is the electrodynamometer type, and in that electrodynamometer type we are having slip ring type and western type synchronoscopes. And next, second one, we are having moving iron type synchronoscopes. Basically we are having two types of synchronoscopes: electrodynamometer type and moving iron type synchronoscopes. And in this chapter we are going to see electrodynamometer type western synchronoscope. So it is a western type synchronoscope, which is nothing but it is one type of electrodynamometer synchronoscope. So here you can see electrodynamometer type synchronoscope, which is also called as western synchronoscope. So here we are having a figure here. So let us see the constructional details of this western synchronoscope. So then it has two main parts. This western synchronoscope has two main parts. So one static part and another is the dynamic part. So the total figure is divided into two parts. So one part is the static part, another part is the dynamic part. So static part consists of three limb transformers. So whatever I have said here, the upper portion, we are having a transformer here. This is the three limb transformer. We are having three limbs here, 1, 2, 3. So this three limb transformer is a static part, and it has three windings. You can see here, 1, 2, 3, and we are having, for three limbs we are having three windings, and in the middle of the limb we are connected a lamp. For the middle winding we have connected a lamp, and the two windings, one winding is connected to the bus bar, and another side one loop winding is connected to the incoming alternator. So here we can see this one. So one of the outermost winding is excited by the bus bar. So you can see here, so this is connected to the bus bars, okay, and the other outermost winding is excited by the incoming alternator. So here, sorry, so these are the bus bars. So one figure just we have missed here. So there will be one more line here. So R line is missing here. So this is the incoming machine. So one winding is connected to the incoming machine, and one winding is connected to the bus bar. So and middle limb winding is connected to the lamp. So here next, the winding of the central limb, that means this is called as the secondary winding. So whatever the these limbs, outermost limbs, two limbs are the primary winding, and this is the secondary winding. As now we know what is the transformer, depending upon the transformer principle, this upper part will work. So coming to the working, so when the instrument is connected between bus bar and incoming alternator, so here, so when this instrument is connected between this bus bar and the incoming alternator, the synchronization switch should be kept open. So this is the synchronization switch. So this is connected between this bus bar and the incoming machine, so this will be opened. So when voltage of the two primaries are in phase, the two primary fluxes in the central limb are additive, so the secondary induced voltage is maximum. So here, so for explanation purpose I want this figure now. So let us see this figure here. I am explaining through this figure. So here, so these two windings are energized by these two voltages. So one voltage is this bus bar voltage, and another voltage is from the incoming machine. So whenever these two are energized, the flux will flow through this a flux will be produced in the this limb, and in this limb also flux will be produced. The flux will flow through this limb to the central limb, and this flux also will produce flow through this to the central limb. Now here, if these two fluxes are additive, that means if the phase sequences are same, so then the two fluxes will become additive here. Therefore the flux will be pi 1 plus pi 2. Let us think that the flux due to this one is pi 1 and flux due to this is pi 2. So pi 1 plus pi 2 will be increased here. That means it is additive. So therefore our bulb will glow. So that is the thing we are going to explain through this. So in this induced voltage in the central limb is maximum. So the lamp glows with maximum brightness, and exact synchronization is obtained. So here, so when the two voltages are in phase, that means if the phase sequences are same, so then the fluxes will be additive. So therefore the lamp will glow. So when the two voltages are 180 degrees out of phase, that means they are not in phase sequence, they are not in equal phase sequence. If they are out of phase, so then the two fluxes will be not additive in nature. So therefore there will be a subtraction, that means pi 1 minus pi 2 like this. So therefore the flux will be decreased in the central limb and it will become to zero. So therefore our bulb will not glow. That means no EMF will be induced in the winding. So due to the opposing phases of the fluxes, so they are not in the same direction, they are in the opposite direction, they will cut each other. So therefore we will get a zero EMF. Therefore our bulb will not glow. So this is called as the lamp will be dark. Okay, coming to the working, before we said that whenever the two fluxes are additive, then the lamp will glow, and if the two fluxes are not additive, that means if the two voltages are not in phase, then the EMF will be zero and the lamp will not glow. So here, and if the frequency of the incoming machine and busbar are not equal, for example, if the frequency, why? Because frequency is also very very important condition that we have to satisfy. So the frequency should be same for the incoming machine and as well as the busbar. So therefore, if the frequency of the incoming machine and busbar are not equal, the lamp will be alternatively bright and dark. That means the lamp will flicker. That means if the frequency of the incoming machine and the busbar are not same, so therefore the lamp will not glow correctly. That means it will flicker. That means it will be on and off and on and off. So therefore, it is called as a flickering. So this will show you that the frequency is not same. So if the lamp is flickering, means continuously flickering, means the frequency is not same. If the lamp is not flickering, that means if it is continuously bright, then we can came to know that the frequency is same as well as the phase sequences are same. So like that we can identify. So for that purpose only we have connected the lamp in the middle limb. So the synchronizing switch should be closed when the lamp flickers at a very slow rate and is at maximum brightness. That means this is the condition, the synchronization condition means here. So we can see here, so whenever the lamp glows, whenever the lamp glows brightly and there will be no flickering, so there will be no more flickering, that shows you that you have to synchronize, you have to close the switch. That means it is the condition is satisfied and you can synchronize your alternator with the busbar. So you can see here, so this is the bulb which indicates you that where you can synchronize or where you can close this synchronization switch. That means if the bulb glows bright and there will be no flickering, so at that condition you have to close this switch. That means you can synchronize, you can connect the incoming machine to the busbar. So a dynamic part in the circuit indicates whether the incoming machine is slow or fast. So here we said that we are having two parts. So coming to this dynamic part in the circuit, that will indicate whether the incoming machine is slow or fast. So this is the dynamic part. So this will show you, this pointer will show you here, this side, left side you are having slow and right side you are having slow, and middle you are having that means actually I think the figure might be wrong. One side should be slow and one side should be fast. So let us see. A fixed coil is divided into two parts. So you can see here in the dynamic part, this is the dynamic part bottom side. So here we are having a fixed coil. So this is the fixed coil which is divided into two parts. So this is the one part and this is the another part. So already we have studied regarding this in our electrodynamic type instruments. So the same type, so here you can see in electrodynamic type instruments we are having a fixed coil which is divided into two equal parts and we are having a moving coil. So you can see here, so these are the two fixed parts and this is the moving coil. So for that moving coil you are connected a pointer. So by showing this we can say that this is the electrodynamometer type instrument. So it carries a small current. So the fixed coil is divided into two parts and this fixed coil will carry small current from the busbar. You can see here I1. So I1 is flowing through this fixed coil and half, and this is the another half of the fixed coil and it is flowing through the inductance and resistance. So this is the current flowing path in the fixed coil. And coming to next, you can see this, it is connected in series with the resistance. You can see here, it is connected in series with the resistance and inductance, and the moving coil is connected in series with the machine. So whatever the moving coil we are having, so here this is connected to fixed coil is connected to the busbar and the moving coil is connected to the incoming machine. So it is connected to the incoming machine, you can see here. So this is the connecting part. So this is connected to the here like this, it is connected to it is in series with the capacitor. So it is connected to a incoming machine. So control springs, all those things are there. So why? Because whenever the pointer is there, definitely it should deflect. For that purpose, deflecting torque should be produced, controlling torque should be there. So all these things should be present. So when the two voltages V1 and V2 are in phase, whatever the condition which is first one, if the V1 and V2 are in phase with each other, the current in the fixed coil I1 and current in the moving coil I2 will be in quadrature with each other. That means, so these two fluxes are same to each other, so therefore there will be no torque on the instrument. That means whatever the torque produced, so the torque is not additive. That means the torque is not useful to produce the deflecting torque, so therefore there will be no torque in the instrument. So this makes the control springs are arranged such that pointer is in the vertical position under these conditions. That means whenever this if there is no torque, the pointer will stay in the middle position only. So like that control springs are arranged. So when the incoming machine voltage leads the busbar voltage V1, that means if the V2 leads the busbar voltage V1, then the torque changes from a negative value through zero to the positive value. So whatever the torque which is produced will become positive value. So therefore our pointer will deflect at that time. The whenever these V1 and V2 are in the same phase also, our lamp will be bright. So the pointer moves on the dial from left to right through the vertical portion. That means you are getting a torque. That means the deflecting torque is produced, and this deflecting torque moves the pointer on the dial from left to right, so through the vertical position. So when the voltages V1 and V2 are 180 out of phase, that means if they are not connected in same phase, that means it is out of phase, the pointer moves back. That means just the condition that is whenever V1 V2 are in 180 degrees, there will be no EMF induced in the middle limb of the transformer. There will be no brightness, the lamp will not glow. So here also what happens, the pointer moves back, so this will not be visible as the lamp remains dark. That's whatever I am saying, that so whenever you are having the 180 degrees of phase between V1 and V2, our lamp will not glow. That means it remains dark, so therefore the pointer will move back, so moves back to the same position. So pointer traverses on the dial in one direction. So the instant of synchronize is when the pointer is visible at its central position and is moving slowly. So that means according to that, if the pointer is in the middle position and the lamp is in bright condition, then it is the chance to switch the synchronization. That means it is a chance to close the switch. Okay, so from this we are able to know that a synchronoscope is a single phase device which is used to determine correct instant of closing the switch of an alternator to the power station busbar. Why? Because for doing this synchronization, I said that a synchronoscope is a very necessary device which makes you to know that the conditions are satisfied by giving this. This is the one method which can say that dark lamp method, or we can say that as a Western synchronoscope will make the lamp to glow and it make the flicker and the pointer to show the slow or fast. So by this we can able to know that the conditions are satisfied. So it is a one type of synchronoscope by which we can able to know when we have to close the synchronization switch between the alternator and the bus bars. So it indicates the differences in phase and frequency of the voltage of bus bars and moving machines. So that means if the lamp is not glowing, means there is a phase difference 180 degrees between V1 and V2, and if the machine is not running, means the frequencies are not same, therefore the lamp will flicker. So by giving this type of indications, it will show you that it is not the good condition to close the switch. And we can able to know that by the diagram. It has two main parts. So one static part, that is the nothing but the transformer. So transformer is a static device, so therefore we can say easily say that it is a static part. And another one is a dynamic part. So dynamic part means in which we are having a fixed coil and moving coil. So that we have seen in the figure. Static part consists of a three limb transformer, which is very very important, because the lamp which we are connected is placed in the middle limb of the transformer which makes you to show that if it is dark or bright. According to that, we can able to know whether the conditions are satisfied or not. And one of the outermost winding is excited by the bus bar, and another outermost winding is excited by the incoming alternator. So whatever the two outermost limbs are there, the two outermost limbs are excited, one by the alternator and another one by the bus bar. So whenever we are having the the same phase sequence, so there the current will flow through the primaries, and therefore lamp will glow in the secondary according to the transformer principle. When the two voltages are one, just we have discussed, the lamp does not glow at all. Why? Because whenever there is no phase sequence, the fluxes will be in opposite in nature. Therefore, they will not become additive. They will become minor. Subtractive means one will take over with another one. So therefore, you will get a difference between that flux, and it makes the lamp not to glow. If the frequency of the incoming machine and the bus bar are not equal, so this is one more condition, the lamp will alternately bright and dark. That means it will flicker. Whenever the lamp is flickering, means according to the by that we can able to know that the frequencies are not same. And when the voltages V1 and V2 are in phase with each other, the pointer moves back. So this is the dynamic part. In the dynamic part, so we can able to know that when the V1 and V2 are in phase each other, the pointer moves back. The instant of synchronize is when the pointer is visible at the central position. If the pointer is at the central position and it is moving slowly and the lamp is in the bright condition, that is the situation where we have to close the synchronization switch. And here we can see some of the frequently asked questions. So just very very important, explain the construction of Western synchronoscope with a neat sketch. And there is a chance to ask you directly, he may ask you to just you to draw the Western synchronoscope for figure, only for figure, or he may ask you to explain the Western synchronoscope with figure. So these are the two questions you can be asked in your examinations. Okay, thank you students. We will see in the next class. Thank you so much.